Hey guys, Athena here. So I've got another video for you guys today. This is now a 20 Blackrock Depths prison. We are currently playing with D-Reg, X9, Winta, and Baba Freak. So I'll kind of go over some of the comp here. I'm running my Manaforge Barrier tank, of course, as Mana Fiend. D-Reg, if I remember correctly, was playing Blood for the Blood God. I'm probably saying that wrong. I'll have to double check it. We'll put it in the description below if it makes sense. X9's playing Molten Earth. Winta is playing Serpent, and we've got Baba Freak on Champion of Justice. So what we've basically done here is we've gone to the left of the prison. We've grabbed the first champion. We've grabbed a second champion, and we're doing both together. Now, this champion pull, it's a little messy, mostly because you can't move these champions very much, even with kicking, and the voids are right on our team, and our team's playing full melee, so we're taking a ton of damage. We're getting really hard carried by our DPS doing damage, as well as Bubba Freak healing through the damage itself. But yeah, a little bit of a messy pull. Our ideal goal was to pull two champions at once. I think actually in this route here, you might actually be even better off skipping the very first champion that we pulled, because it just has double the health of other champions. Right now, we're just trying to basically kill it. We're just going to move back in line of sight. We basically stood in two voids, took a shit ton of damage for no reason. So we're playing this pretty poorly. Ideally, what you want to do with these type of champions, though, is when you see the void spawn, you move away from it. The champion comes with you. It'll spawn another void spawn, or not void spawn. I keep calling them that because the minions, but singularities. And then you just move to the other side and avoid them. But that's mainly the whole thing here. So we've killed two champions. Goals, we're going to kill three more. One of the reasons why I want to show you guys this video is not only is it a relatively good run, we got a two chest, 19 minutes. But we also take a different route. We don't do the heroic leap or pet pulling, which happens a lot in these kind of runs in prison for time runs. So this is great for you pugs that don't have someone that can do heroic leap or do pet pulls, but you still want to push a high time. That's one of the best things about this. So now we're going into the middle room. We're mostly just going to clear most of this. This middle room part is just good percentage. There's also a champion in here, and there's usually a second champion as well. If you get the right pathing, there's two champions in the middle room. So we're gathering them here. I'm mostly just trying to make sure I have threat on mobs because of the convention of the elements. Not too much here. Really, just grab what you're comfortable with and keep in mind that there is a champion in the center room. So sometimes grabbing everything can be dangerous, especially if there's a champion aspect. I believe now that we've got enough dead, I'm going to probably actually go and grab the champion. Yep, here we go. So we grab the champion, we grab the rest of the trash, and then we're going to probably slowly bring this champion downwards. So you see the singularities are being spawned. So I move the champion away so we don't take singularity damage. Then another singularity will spawn here, and we're just gonna and that one actually spawned away from us, so I don't even move it. Again, that's all you have to really do this week for the affix. It's pretty straightforward. So I notice we're not taking a lot of damage, so I just start moving it in. So we're gonna go in. We don't need anything else here. We're going for the first boss, the interrogator. This route doesn't grab too many boons, actually. I think we could probably optimize more boons. There's a few more runs I want to show you guys once we get a little bit more cleaner routes for that actually have some really nice boons. I have a really good lubers that I want to show you guys soon. Actually, what do you guys think about that? If I did videos, if the runs aren't perfect, do you guys still want to see the routes in a video? Or do you guys want to wait until I've actually got a perfect a pull done, because I've got some really good luber footage, but it doesn't, they're not perfect. We wipe and fuck up a little bit, but we can definitely do them. We just have to get the right group again and pull. So we kill the champion. The only thing you gotta be careful about here, and you notice where I stop, is that there's normally a mob that patrols back and forth between the two, and I thought we didn't catch it, so I stopped looking for it, and I'm like, wait, where is this? There's no pathing mob. So I wasted time. We could have just kept running forward. Just make sure you grab the two dogs and the one dwarf and you're good. Now, if you remember correctly, I mentioned that in the middle room that there's two champions. The second one paths all around like a U-shape of this boss room. You can technically go and pull the interrogator down to the bottom of this room and keep an eye out for the champion and pull the champion into it. That is absolutely a strategy for it, and you can kill it, and it's actually really good. If you don't catch it here, it'll most likely be in the center room and you can pull it there. Both are great because they have really low health pulls in comparative to the other champions. So nothing too fancy. Bosses are pretty straightforward this week. They're not tyrannical. Interrogator, you know, just kick the mana drains, make sure the fears are being dealt with. If not, it's just 4 seconds of time loss. Nothing crazy here. There is a boon in the room here, but we already get so much percentage that I don't think it's even worth it. Because you're already hitting percentage caps. So the skips that you can skip for mobs is kind of inconvenient. I don't think it's worth pulling extra trash just to get that boon. But there is a boon to our right now. So we're gonna run out. The champion's right outside. We caught it in the perfect pathing. So we grab this champion and we kill it. And I bring this champion along because at this point here, we need to keep moving. If we're gonna make a good time, we can't just stop for one champion. So the goal now of what we're going to do after we've dealt with the interrogator, we're going to go down to Rakor. Rakor can go anywheres. So because of the changes that they made to the arena, you can no longer do Rakor with the arena RP. Because of that, we're going to actually bring him down to Houndmaster, which will get us our second and third bosses done together. So you can do double boss is a really good reason. 90% of the time. A lot of times, Rakor usually will die before you get to Houndmaster if you have a good enough DPS group. But if you do kill all the trash and you get him down, that's a good double boss moment. So we grab Rakor, and now I'm just going to keep moving him down slowly. And we're going to keep killing trash packs as we move him closer and closer down to the Hound pack. Again, we're really just trying to optimize any time loss that we can do here. One thing to keep in mind about these mobs, though, is you can notice I have lost armor reduction. These mobs apply a stacking armor debuff that can really hurt you tanks, so be careful, as well as disarms, stuns, knockdowns, bleeds. There's a lot of damage that happens here. Mana Forge Barrier can negate some of these, so I'm kind of just free-rolling as I'm just kicking butt. You can see Baba Freaks in the back. He's actually trying to stay at max range so that he doesn't get knocked down and CC'd. As you can tell, I am taking a lot of damage because we are doing really, really big pulls here. Trying to clear as many mobs as possible because we have a lot of AoE. So we can get these killed really quickly and keep moving onwards. Once we get this done, we're going to go down, we're going to grab the Houndmaster, kill the Houndmaster, have that done. Afterwards, I almost die there, oh my gosh, it's kind of a little crazy. Once we kill Houndmaster, normally what you guys would do is you'd run up, you'd go into arena, you start the RP, you kill that boss, and then you run up, you do Pyromancer. Because of the Pyromancer, or because of the RP, arena takes a ton of time. You have to wait for the guy to walk up, do his little speech, summon the first set of adds, kill them all, get him go back, do the next speech to summon the boss. During that time, you can't do anything if you're inside there with the RP. So normally what people will do is they'll have heroic leap where you can leap up to the top of the arena and pull the arena mobs. And if you don't have Heroic Leap, then you use a pet. You send the pet through the door and it pulls for everyone. So we killed Rockor. We're going to go into the room and we're going to horn. If you're not comfortable with doing the whole room, don't worry. Just pull what you can. If you pull the Houndmaster, though, the Houndmaster will pull everything. So we had Boon. So we just popped Boon here. Boons are really good for massive pulls or double bosses or anytime that you know you're just going to need to dish out a ton of damage. Like, I am taking a ton, so I'm glad that we Booned here because I really needed it. I think we lose Winta here, too. Yeah, Winta ends up dying. He gets one tap, unfortunately. That was because I couldn't target the Houndmaster and he single target ripped it. So because of that, we lose our single target DPS and this takes a lot longer than we would have liked it to, unfortunately. But that's okay. Minor details like that happen. It would have been nice if we had a battle res, but we didn't. So instead, our group does not have a heroic leap, nor does it have a pet. So I'm going to show you guys the route that we ended up using that I think is only a few seconds slower and can still save you a lot of time and is very helpful. Also, we had this all recorded live on stream, by the way. We were doing this live at twitch.tv/AthenaKaiGames. So if you guys like that, if you like watching people do live keys and us theory crafting and talking about like where we think certain pulls should be and discussing like our actual pulls and the real-time bots, you guys should go check out my stream. I stream almost every day and I'm normally doing Mythic Plus or some other form of content in Ascension. So we turn on pack and we start running up. Now you see Baba is about to go in there and I'm like, no, Baba, no, 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 other way. We're going a different way. So you cut through these and you're going to go back to the first room where we pulled the second champion from. And we're going to take this pathing. Now, one thing I would really recommend actually doing instead is see the champion to our left there, that fire guard. You should actually pull that fire guard. So instead of pulling the very first fire guard that we pulled in the start of this key, you want to grab the second, that one there, because it actually has half the HP. It's ridiculous. It's completely ridiculous. The HP is different. So I grab all these up on the arena and then I jump down and I start the RP and I get one of my DPS to grab the third one. They go over, they grab the last one, they jump down. We have the RP starting. This is the same as someone doing a heroic leap. The only difference is that it takes us a little bit longer because we have to run around. But that's okay. We get a really good pull here. We bring out the big high AoE. We're doing a bunch of damage. I can't remember. I feel like no one dies here. I think we're good. I'm like, wait, did Winta die again in this one? I don't think Winta dies here. Just be careful because, yeah, these mobs do a ton of damage. X9 almost dies. I was stressing because I don't have Taunt in this build. And I was like, oh no, if he dies because I lose threat, I'm gonna be a sad potato. I don't know what it is. I don't know if it's my build or it's just these ads. But these free ads, like, for the boss, fucking hurt. Like, straight up, guys. Like, they hurt a shit ton. Like, I don't understand it. But recently, doing these pulls, these like bats and stuff do tons of damage to me. So just be careful. Make sure you've got your defenses ready and your healers not in melee, because if so, they'll get war stomped and or thunderclapped by the bats and they'll go silent and then they can't cast anything. So very little downtime. As you guys saw, we basically killed all the adds on the top of the arena. There was a couple that got reset, but that's okay. And then we killed all them with almost no downtime. So we're gonna kill this boss, then we're gonna go up to Pyromancer. And that will finish up the key. Now there is one more champion in the Pyromancer room that we're gonna be doing. And that's the final champion. So again, in this route here, like I said, if you skip the first champion, you do the second champion, the two in the middle room, the one before the arena, and then the final one. I think that's the most optimal champions, as they all have the lowest HP pools in comparison to the current, like the first one that we pulled, which is like at 1.3 million health, and the rest of them are at like 800k. These last few bosses don't really do anything exciting. It's really just the ads, so we're just gonna take those out. One thing to keep in mind, I guess I could talk about, is the ads on the top of the arena. There's medics. You want to prioritize medics. Make sure you're kicking, CCing, and deep damage dealing them. They're the most top priority for those. So went to pulled the two Anger Forge, that's fine. I get dazed. We grab them and we start keep running as soon as I got the threat. Okay, so we grab these. We grab the next set of ads and we bring them up with it because we've already got these pulled. We're gonna kill these. And the reason why we wanna kind of be careful with this is because there is a champion that is passing and we don't wanna have the champion pulled. So we take care of this. And then we're gonna go and I think we're gonna do the next pack with the champion and then we're gonna do the boss. And we're gonna get it all done kind of together. Alright, so yeah, we go in, we see the DPS here, grab these packs. The champion is pathing back to us now as we're pulling this. We can see it, it's right there. So we start the damage here and we're ready as soon as the champion comes. We're gonna grab it and we're gonna bring it into boss. The last bit of this is pretty straightforward though. Nothing too crazy that we have to really worry about. Already killed all the minions. We run straight into the champion. And now we grab this. There is a lot of damage that happens right at the start here, but that's because the champion, I believe, got rally. Other than that, though, there's nothing really. We actually just tank through it. We don't even move. We just let the healer heal through the damage, and we just keep focusing the boss and the champion. Double cleave it down, and a nice, clean, relatively smooth run. Only one death with Winta, but otherwise it was really good. Okay, guys, if you like this kind of content, let me know. I really enjoy kind of going over these, as well as talk about the affixes each week and how we can kind of improve and make the Mythic Plus scene in Ascension better. If you guys have a dungeon that you think that would be the most like difficult or something you really want to know about, you guys should leave a comment about it, because I'd love to cover dungeons that people feel like are like the biggest struggles or like the hardest to grasp in routing, or how to handle certain aspects of it. Maybe it's the mobs or the bosses or the affixes themselves. Because right now, I believe, I think this video is going to come out beforehand, but I will have a video covering the affixes in this video with all of the week 5 deals and kind of what each one of them does in detail and how you sort of handle them. So I hope you guys kind of enjoyed those styles as well. Well, thanks for the video, everyone. I'll see you in the next one and have a wonderful day.